In this example, we are given that the length of seconds hand in a watch is 1 centimeter. And we are required to find the magnitude of change in velocity of its tip in 15 seconds. We are also required to find the magnitude of average acceleration during this interval. Now, in solution, step by step we can proceed it. If we just talk about the time period of seconds hand in a watch, this time period we know well that it is 60 seconds. And if we know the time period, we can find out its angular velocity. This implies angular velocity is, this is written as 2 pi by t. So, if we put t equal to 60, this will become pi by 30 radian per second. That is the angular speed at which the seconds hand in a watch rotates. We are given that length of the seconds hand is 1 centimeter. So, we talk about velocity of tip of seconds hand is, in case of revolution, a speed can be written as r omega. The length of the second hand is 1 centimeter. So, it can be written as 1 into pi by 30. It is pi by 30 centimeters per second. Now, we are required to find the change in velocity in 15 seconds. We know that in a watch, in 15 seconds, the second hand rotates by an angle 90 degree. Because in 1 minute, in 60 seconds, it revolves complete one revolution. So, we can state simply in 15 seconds, it rotates by 90 degree. So, initially the velocity vector of the tip would be in this direction, say that is V1. Finally, it is in this direction, say it is V2. So, if we find out the change in velocity in 15 seconds, this delta V can be written as V2 minus V1 vector. If we just draw the velocity triangle, so V2 vector is in downward direction. Its magnitude remains same, that is pi by 30. V1 vector is toward right, so minus V1 vector will be in this direction. This V2 vector, this minus V1 vector. So, this will be the change in velocity, it is delta V. As both of these vectors are same in magnitude, its magnitude can be written as root 2 into pi by 30 centimeters per second. Because if it is V, it is V, this will be root 2V. By Pythagoras, we can directly calculate it. Now, the direction will be this. Direction can also be given if we are required to find. Using this, we can find out the average acceleration. Average acceleration vector can be simply written as delta V vector by delta t. We know that in 15 seconds, it's rotated by 90 degrees. So, change in velocity can be given by this. And time is 15 seconds. So, we can simply write as root 2 pi by 30 divided by 15. The result will get as root 2 pi by 450 centimeters per second square. So, these are the answers to this problem.